हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम मनोज, डूइंग माय मास्टर्स इन स्पेशल इंफॉर्मेशन साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग, यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ मेन। आई विल टॉक रिगार्डिंग माय रिसर्च इंटरेस्ट इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन। लेट्स स्टार्ट विद सम मोटिवेशन फॉर माय वर्क। अकॉर्डिंग टू द वर्ल्ड हेल्थ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन रिपोर्ट्स, इट इज एस्टिमेटेड दैट देर आर 45 मिलियन पीपल हु आर लीगली ब्लाइंड, एंड ऑफ विच मोर देन 90% ऑफ द पीपल लिव इन लो इनकम कंट्रीज। वन स्टडी टेल्स दैट For an average user, the percentage of time spent within building is 87, which is quite high, and of which more than 15% of the time is spent in unfamiliar indoor places. The highly successful outdoor positioning system, the GPS, cannot provide reliable indoor positioning. So, there is a clear need for a robust and reliable indoor positioning and navigation system with special requirements for blind and low vision users, a non-visual navigation system for blind. My research focus revolves on two main questions. Can we build an indoor positioning and navigation system for blind with reasonable accuracy? What are the interfaces that will be effective for indoor navigation for low vision and blind users? Talking about accuracy in indoor positioning, we can think about two categories. One is Euclidean accuracy, other is topological accuracy. Euclidean accuracy refers to the accuracy based on straight line distance between the user's actual position and estimated position. Topology deals with connections, containment, and adjacencies. To better explain the topological accuracy, let's consider this building layout. The star marker denotes the user's actual position in the building. The green dot marker denotes a topologically correct positioning estimate, as it is in the same room as the user's actual position. The red dot marker denotes a topologically incorrect positioning estimate. Though this red marker is very close to the user's actual position, there is a wall between them, which makes it topologically incorrect. Now we'll discuss some ways of indoor positioning. Well, it's better to use existing infrastructure like Wi-Fi for indoor positioning rather than having to build new infrastructural changes which are costly and often not feasible. Also, we should try to use the sensors available in smartphones, which are more popular nowadays. Sensors like accelerometer and orientation sensors can be used to detect users' motion and heading, and this can be used for dead reckoning. Also, most phones come with an optical sensor, that is the camera, which can be used to detect optical markers in an indoor space. We should avoid high-cost, custom-built user navigational devices. We should use off-the-shelf hardware like smartphones. As a part of this work, we have developed a simple prototype for indoor positioning. The screenshot shows a Java-based application developed using GeoTools, a GIS library in Java. Here the blue dots show the positions where the Wi-Fi signal strengths are recorded and stored in a backend Oracle database. And the green circle shows the user's correct position detected using Naive-based algorithm. The red line shows the route generated based on Dijkstra algorithm from the current position to the room number 234. Another way of approaching the indoor positioning problem is by the use of indoor building layout maps. These maps show the walls and other impassable constraints in an indoor space. Consider the layout of the building. The red line shows the user's position tracked without the knowledge of the building layout, and it shows up that it passes through a wall, which is not true. The green line shows the user's position tracked with the knowledge of the building layout, and this time it passes through the door. This is similar to the road matching techniques that are available in car navigation GPS systems. So, to build a robust indoor positioning system, we have to fuse or combine the earlier techniques like Wi-Fi, map matching, and dead reckoning. The next is navigational interfaces. The main two categories are non-visual and visual. Vision-based interfaces are not suitable for blind. They require audio or haptic-based interfaces for indoor navigation. Also, non-visual interfaces are required by emergency personnel during certain emergency situations like smoke or fire. Visual interfaces sometimes become intrusive depending on the task and place. Non-visual interfaces, when coupled with visual interface, becomes a universal interface design, suitable for all people. Also, it becomes a multimodal interface. Some examples of non-visual interfaces are specialized audio, vibration, touchscreen, and directional probes. Examples of visual interfaces are 2D maps, 3D maps, semantic maps. Our current work deals with developing an indoor positioning and navigation system for blind using smartphones. We are using Android-powered Motorola Droid device for this purpose. This work is supported by NSF and NIH grants. For more details, visit the links shown.